I am Ra. I greet you in the love and the light of our infinite creator. We communicate now. Question 9.1. Questioner, is it possible for you to tell us anything about our past experiences, our past incarnations before this incarnation? Answer, I am Ra. It is possible. However, such information as this is carefully guarded by your mind, body, spirit, being, totality, so that your present space-time experiences will be undiluted. Let us scan for harmless material for your beingness. I am, in the distortion of desire for your freedom from preconception, able to speak only generally. There have been several times when this group worked and dwelt together. The relationships varied. There is balanced karma, as you call it, each thus teacher of each. The work has involved healing, understanding the uses of the earth energy, and work in aid of civilizations which called just as your sphere has done, and we have come. This ends the material which we consider harmless. Question 9.2. Questioner, the healing exercises that you gave us are of such a nature that it is best to concentrate on a particular exercise at a certain time. I would like to ask what exercise that I should concentrate on tonight? Answer, I am Ra. Again, to direct your judgment is an intrusion upon your space-time continuum distortion called future. To speak of past or present within our distortion judgment limits is acceptable. To guide rather than teach learn is not acceptable to our distortion in regards to teach learning. We, instead, can suggest the process whereby each chooses the first of the exercises given in the order in which we gave them, which you, in your discernment, feel is not fully appreciated by your mind, body, spirit complex. This is the proper choice, building from the foundation, making sure the ground is good for the building. We have assessed for you the intensity of this effort in terms of energy expended. You will take this in mind and be patient, for we have not given a short or easy program of consciousness learn teaching. Question 9.3. Questioner, the way that I understand the process of evolution is that our planetary population has a certain amount of time to progress. This is generally divided into 3 25,000-year cycles. At the end of 75,000 years the planet progresses itself. What caused this situation to come about with the preciseness of the years in each cycle? Answer, I am Ra. Visualize, if you will, the particular energy which, outward flowing and inward coagulating, formed the tiny realm of the creation governed by your Council of Saturn. Continue seeing the rhythm of this process. The living flow creates a rhythm which is as inevitable as one of your timepieces. Each of your planetary entities began the first cycle when the energy nexus was able in that environment to support such mind-body experiences. Thus, each of your planetary entities is on a different cyclical schedule, as you might call it. The timing of these cycles is a measurement equal to a portion of intelligent energy. This intelligent energy offers a type of clock. The cycles move as precisely as a clock strikes your hour. Thus, the gateway from intelligent energy to intelligent infinity opens regardless of circumstance on the striking of the hour. Question 9.4. Questioner, the original, first entities on this planet, what was their origin? Where were they before they were on this planet? Answer, I am Ra. The first entities upon this planet were water, fire, air and earth. Question 9.5. Questioner, where did the people who are like us, who were the first ones here, where did they come from? From where did they evolve? Answer, I am Ra. You speak of third density experience. The first of those to come here were brought from another planet in your solar system called by you the red planet, Mars. This planet's environment became inhospitable to third density beings. The first entities, therefore, were of this race, as you may call it, manipulated somewhat by those who were guardians at that time. Question 9.6. Questioner, what race is that, and how did they get from Mars to here? Answer, I am Ra. The race is a combination of the mind, body, spirit complexes of those of your so-called red planet and a careful series of genetical adjustments made by the guardians of that time. These entities arrived, or were preserved, for the experience upon your sphere by a type of bathing which is non-reproductive, but consists of preparing genetic material for the incarnation of the mind, body, spirit complexes of those entities from the red planet. Question 9.7. Questioner, I assume from what you are saying that the Guardians transferred the race here after the race had died from the physical as we know it on Mars. Is that correct? Answer, I am Ra. This is correct. Question 9.8. Questioner, the Guardians were obviously acting within an understanding of the Law of One in doing this. Can you explain the application of the Law of One in this process? Answer, I am Ra. The Law of One was named by these Guardians as the bringing of the wisdom of the Guardians in contact with the entities from the Red Planet, thus molding the social memory complex of the Guardian race and the Red Planet race. It, however, took an increasing amount of distortion into the application of the Law of One from the viewpoint of other Guardians, and it is from this beginning action that the quarantine of this planet was instituted, for it was felt that the free will of those of the Red Planet had been abridged. Question 9.9. Questioner, were the entities of the Red Planet following the Law of One prior to leaving the Red Planet? Answer, I am Ra. The entities of the Red Planet were attempting to learn the laws of love, which form one of the primal distortions of the Law of One. However, the tendencies of these people towards bellicose actions caused such difficulties in the atmospheric environment of their planet that it became inhospitable for third density experience before the end of its cycle. Thus, the Red Planet entities were unharvested and continued in your illusion to attempt to learn the Law of Love. Question 9.10. Questioner, how long ago did this transfer occur from the Red Planet to Earth? Answer, I am Ra. In your time this transfer occurred approximately 75,000 years ago. Question 9.11. Questioner, 75,000 years ago. Answer, I am Ra. This is approximately correct. Question 9.12. Questioner, were there any entities of the form that I am now, two arms, two legs, on this planet before this transfer occurred? Answer, I am Ra. There have been visitors to your sphere at various times for the last 4 million of your years, speaking approximately. These visitors do not affect the cycling of the planetary sphere. It was not third density in its environment until the time previously mentioned. Question 9.13. Questioner, then there were second density entities here prior to approximately 75,000 years ago. What type of entities were these? Answer, I am Ra. The second density is the density of the higher plant life and animal life which exists without the upward drive towards the infinite. These second density beings are of an octave of consciousness, just as you find various orientations of consciousness among the conscious entities of your vibration. Question 9.14. Questioner, did any of these second density entities have shapes like ours, two arms, two legs, a head, and walk upright on 2 feet? Answer, I am Ra. The two higher of the subvibrational levels of second density beings had the configuration of the biped, as you mentioned. However, the erectile movement which you experience was not totally affected in these beings who were tending towards the leaning forward, barely leaving the quadrupedal position. Question 9.15. Questioner, where did these beings come from? Were they a product of evolution as understood by our scientists? Were they evolved from the original material of the Earth that you spoke of? Answer, I am Ra. This is correct. Question 9.16. Questioner, do these beings then evolve from second density to third density? Answer, I am Ra. This is correct, although no guarantee can be made of the number of cycles it will take an entity to learn the lessons of consciousness of self, which are the prerequisite for transition to third density. Question 9.17. Questioner, is there any particular race of people on our planet now who were incarnated here from second density? Answer, I am Ra. There are no second density consciousness complexes here on your sphere at this time. However, there are two races which use the second density form. One is the entities from the planetary sphere you call Moldek. These entities are working their understanding complexes through a series of what you would call karmic restitutions. They dwell within your deeper underground passageways and are known to you as Bigfoot. the other race as that being offered a dwelling in this density by guardians who wish to give the mind, body, spirit complexes of those who are of this density at this time appropriately engineered physical vehicles, as you would call these chemical complexes, in the event that there is what you call nuclear war. Question 9.18. Questioner, I didn't understand what these vehicles or beings were for that were appropriate in the event of nuclear war. Answer, I am Ra. These are beings which exist as instinctual second density beings which are being held in reserve to form what you would call a gene pool in case these body complexes are needed. These body complexes are greatly able to withstand the rigors of radiation which the body complexes you now inhabit could not do. Question 9.19. Questioner, where are these body complexes located? Answer, I am Ra. These body complexes of the second race dwell in uninhabited deep forest. There are many in various places over the surface of your planet. Question 9.20. Questioner, are they Bigfoot-type creatures? Answer, I am Ra. This is correct, although we would not call these Bigfoot as they are scarce and are very able to escape detection. The first race is less able to be aware of proximity of other mind, body, spirit complexes, but these beings are very able to escape due to their technological understandings before their incarnations here. These entities of the glowing eyes are those most familiar to your peoples. Question 9.21. Questioner, then there are two different types of Bigfoot. Correct. Answer, I am Ra. This will be the final question. There are three types of Bigfoot if you will accept that vibratory sound complex used for three such different races of mind, body, spirit complexes. The first two we have described. The third is a thought form. Question 9.22. Questioner, I would like to ask if there is anything that we can do to aid the instrument's comfort. Answer, I am Ra. This instrument will require some adjustment of the tender portions of her body complex. The distortions are due to the energy center blockage you would call pineal. I leave you in the love and the light of the one infinite creator. Go forth, therefore, rejoicing in the power and the peace of the one creator. Adonai.